everyone. Hope everyone is doing great. Welcome to another video. So our today's video is a bit interesting. So today we are going to look into another interesting topic related to the applications of latest technologies in construction industry. And as you can see in this first slide, that today the topic of our today's discussion is smart cities. What are smart cities? So first we will discuss and try to understand the basic definition of smart cities, right? And what actually is a smart city. Then I will share a brief report of CNBC, which will help us to understand the smart cities more clearly. So I think let's start first with the definition of smart cities. What actually is a smart city? What kind of city we call a smart city? So a smart city is a technologically modern urban area that uses different type of electronic methods, voice activation methods and sensors to collect specific data, right? So the main basic aim is to collect data. So the information gained from that data are used to manage assets, resources, services efficiency, services efficiently, and in return that data is used to improve the operations across the city, that smart city. So this includes data collection from citizens, different devices, buildings and assets that is then processed and then analyzed to monitor and manage different sort of services like traffic and transportation systems, power plants, utilities, water supply systems or water supply networks, waste, crime detection, information systems, schools, libraries, hospitals and other community services. So the smart city concept actually integrates information and communication technology, which we call ICT, and various physical devices connected to the Internet of Things network. That network is called IoT, right? Internet of Things, to optimize the efficiency of city operations and services and connect to the citizens of that city. So smart city technology allows city officials or government officials to interact directly with both community and the city infrastructure and to monitor what is happening in the city and how the city is evolving. So the another application of the latest technologies in a smart city is that the information and communication technology ICT is used to enhance quality, performance and interactivity of urban services, to reduce costs and resource consumption and to increase contact between citizens and the government. Got it. So this is actually the definition of what actually is a smart city and what are the applications of smart city. So let's look into a picture. This picture will help us to understand what we have discussed in the earlier slide. So in a smart city, everything, every facility and every component will be smart, right? Like smart manufacturing, smart government, mobility and Wi-Fi, smart digital citizens, open data, smart health, smart transportation, smart farming and agriculture, smart buildings, smart grids, smart plants, smart energy and smart utilities, smart transportation. So everything, every component, every activity in the city will be smart. Smart means everything will be connected, everything will be digital and everything will be connected to the latest technologies. So that sort of city is called smart city. Like we have some examples. Singapore has been developed as a smart city. Barcelona, there is a smart city. I guess India is also developing a smart city. South Korea is also developing a smart city. So with the passage of time, the developed countries are trying to convert their cities into smart cities. So to make it more clear, actually I want to show you a video which I have discussed in the my first slide, that there is a channel CNBC which has made a small clip related to smart cities, and they have tried to explain what actually is a smart city is. So let's go into that video and let's listen to the reporter what he is explaining about the smart cities. That will help us to make the things more clear. Okay, let's play the video.
Just how smart is your city? Chances are it's getting smarter by the year. Many governments around the globe are racing to infuse technology into just about every aspect of its city's operations. And I mean every part.
Including public transportation, IT connectivity, water and power supply, sanitation and solid waste management, efficient urban mobility, e-governance, and citizen participation.
And it does this using every buzzword imaginable, from big data to the Internet of Things.
So how does a smart city work? Let's look at three examples.
Here in Singapore, the city-state might be the gold standard of the most extensive effort to collect data on daily living.
The government is now deploying systems that can tell when people are smoking in prohibited zones or littering from high-rise housing.
Singapore launched its own Smart Nation program in 2014 and will add more cameras like these so the government can effectively monitor crowd density, cleanliness of public spaces, and even the exact movement of every locally registered vehicle.
Much of the data it's collecting will be fed into an online platform called Virtual Singapore that gives the government access to how the city is functioning in real time. It could help the government predict how crowds might react to an explosion in a shopping mall, or how infectious disease might spread. Over in Dubai, more than 50 smart services from 22 government entities have been rolled out as part of the government's Smart Dubai initiative. Using the government-provided app Dubai Now, you can do things like pay a speeding ticket, which likely captured you on a public camera and then emailed you the ticket directly. You can also use the same app to pay your electric bill, call a taxi, track a package you sent to your friend, find the nearest ATM, renew your vehicle registration, track the visa status of a relative, and report a violation to the Dubai police. Now head over to Barcelona, where one research firm estimates the city will save billions of dollars a year in energy costs just by installing smart systems like these. Number one, smart streetlights, public lighting that adapts and dims when there's no activity but brightens up when sensors detect motion. The second, parking sensors. Instead of driving in circles looking for a spot to park, drivers can get real-time information on an app which locates free parking spots. Sensors on the street curb use lighting and metal detectors to know if a parking spot or loading area is occupied. And finally, garbage sensors, which are actually compact drop-off containers which have a vacuum network through pipes which sucks up trash below ground. The automated waste collection not only lowers noise pollution from garbage trucks, but also lowers costs and keeps bad odor away. Juniper Research estimates that by 2021, cities will save nearly $19 billion by making their cities smart.
But of course, to save money, sometimes you have to spend it first. The global smart city market is estimated to attract $15 billion by 2021, and that's just for software. So now companies from Microsoft to Cisco are aiming for a piece of it. In Singapore, Upton Saidi, CNBC.
So that was the video. So I hope you guys understood what actually a smart city is. So in coming videos, we will discuss more applications of the latest technologies and their application in the construction industry, like big data, sensors, robotics, artificial intelligence, machine learning, and much more. So for today's, I think that's it. So thank you for watching the video. See you guys in the next video with something new. So till then, goodbye. Take good care. See you guys in next video. Thank you so much.